Every nation sees the glory of the star that pierced the night. As we tell the wondrous story, we are bathed in radiant light. Star sent forth from highest heaven, dancing light of God's design. Shine on the gift that's given, Word made flesh, now born in time. Every tongue shall sing the praises of his birth in deepest night. He is healing for the ages. He is Christ, our God's delight. He proclaims within his being all our hopes, our great desires. He shall die to rise, redeeming all who follow with their lives.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening, Father.
This year, we celebrate Epiphany on its traditional day, as January 6th happens to fall on a Sunday. Falling 12 days after Christmas, this was regarded as enough time for the Magi to travel to Bethlehem from foreign lands. With their arrival, Jesus is now manifest to the outside world. Just as the star in the east symbolizes the light of Christ shining for the whole world to see, we are called to manifest Christ in our lives so others can realize the good news wherever they go.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, High Priest of all peoples, your light shines on all nations. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, Prophet of all ages, you announce the good news. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, King over all nations, you rescue the poor. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King. O God, Almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of good will. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You Take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand, the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth. Good will. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. May the splendor of your majesty, O Lord, we pray, shed its light upon our hearts, that we may pass through the shadows of this world and reach the brightness of our eternal home. Through our Lord, Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow, for the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you. Dromedaries from Midian and Ephah, all from Sheba, shall come bearing gold and frankincense, and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Our responsorial psalm is number 1011 in the hymnal. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. O God, give your judgment for the king, to a king's son his justice, that he may judge your people in justice and you're poor in right judgment. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. In his days shall justice flourish, and great peace till the moon is no more. He shall rule from sea to sea, from the river to the bounds of the earth. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. The kings of Tarshish and the islands shall pay him tribute. The kings of Sheba and Seba shall bring him gifts. Before him all kings shall fall prostrate. All nations shall serve him. Lord, every nation on earth will adore. For he shall save the needy when they cry, the poor and those who are helpless. He will have pity on the weak and the needy, and save the lives of the needy. Lord, every nation on earth will adore.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations. It has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Spirit and life, you have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ has to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word that I too may go and do him homage." After the audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them, until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed and seeing the star. And on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we are celebrating the Feast of the Epiphany. It is the second of four great manifestations of God in our midst. The first of these four manifestations we already celebrated December 25th, the Nativity of the Lord. God manifested his glory, but in the simplicity of a baby lying in a manger. The shepherds are those who receive this glorious manifestation. The second manifestation is today, feast, and I will share about this in my homily. The third manifestation we will celebrate next Sunday at a feast closes the Christmas season. This will be the feast of the baptism of the Lord Jesus. Jesus, as an adult, is seen standing in a river together with a multitude of penitents. At the moment of his baptism, a voice from heaven manifested he is the Son of God. And the last, the fourth revelation, is found only in John's Gospel, the wedding at Cana. We will read this Gospel on the second Sunday of the ordinary time, immediately after Christmas season. This passage of the Gospel has a lot of symbolism. The new covenant in Jesus is the new wine. But today, we are still liturgically focused on the second of the four manifestations, the Feast of the Epiphany. At its center is a concept of tremendous significance. This Feast of the Epiphany helped change the conviction of the people of Israel that they were the exclusive people of God. This liturgical feast moves our hearts to the comprehension that God is a God of all the peoples. In today's gospel, we contemplate strangers, foreigners, coming to give royal homage to this child. I want to illustrate the meaning of this Feast of the Epiphany with a past event that we had in our parish at the beginning of December. Do you remember the Living Nativity? I saw many of you enjoyed That performance that was really well prepared by many people of our parish and inclusive with live animals. During the living nativity, who did you see riding on the camels? Father Thomas, Father John, and me, Father Fabian. Or a priest from India, from Guatemala, from the United States. We have seen a glimpse of the universality of the salvation in our own parish. The three priests who you saw represent the fruit of the universal action of God, who broke down all the barriers of tribe, kinship, language, and nation. But what do we learn from these magi who arrived from the East? The tradition says they were three, but the gospel did not mention that were three. The tradition deduced that from the three gifts that were given to Jesus. The tradition said that they were kings. Again, the gospel did not mention that. The tradition started to call them kings inspired by the Old Testament prophecies that describe the Messiah being worshipped by kings. Anyway, I think the most important is what the Word of God wants to communicate today. The first scene of our today's gospel, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star and its rising, and have come to do him homage." These wise men made a long trip and arrived in Jerusalem. For Matthew, Jerusalem was the center of the Jewish power and faith. These wise men traveled to Jerusalem because it was the center, and that seemed like the logical place to look for a king. The Magi expected to find fulfillment of their search within Jerusalem. Instead of finding light, they found darkness in their encounter with Herod. Jerusalem, unfortunately, was in darkness. That place became darkened by these people of power. Beginning with Herod himself, the only thing that interested him was power. It's obvious from the story that Herod's intentions were not good. Also, at Jerusalem were the religious leaders of Israel, the chief priests and the scribes, experts in the scriptures. Although clearly aware of where the Messiah would be born, they didn't seem to make any effort to investigate. They had the knowledge, but not the light or understanding that those wise men certainly had. The Old Testament passages indicate that God intended the Jewish people to be a light for all nations. That was their mission. Whether the message was misunderstood or the people were not yet ready, the message was kept for themselves. For that reason, when they heard from the Magi that the new king was born, Herod was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Their power was at risk. They were not prepared for that. The Magi, upon leaving Herod, saw the star with its light again. They were overjoyed and seeing the star. The Magi's expectations were suddenly turned upside down. Their search ended with the finding of the baby Jesus in his humble estate. They also learned that they should not return to the darkness, to Jerusalem. We sometimes look for God in the wrong places. God is everywhere, we know that is true, but sometimes God is not where we want God to be or where it is more comfortable for us. And even worse, when we want to make God as something exclusive to us. That only reflects attitudes of exclusion that we could have towards others. To have this experience of finding God, we can learn from the experience of the Magi. The wise men saw the star and followed it. The people in Jerusalem did not. The Magi show us that finding God is a journey, is a pilgrimage, following a star. Not in the sense of the colloquial expression, he or she follows his or her star. This expression, from what I understand in the colloquial English, is more in the sense of following the success in your life. The star, in the biblical meaning, is more in the sense of walking our daily life to find God. Following a star, not your own or my own star. And that sometimes represents walking in ways never expected in our life. Our looking for Jesus lasts our entire life. One day we will contemplate in his total radiance. That is our hope. But meanwhile, while we walk our daily life, we need to have our eyes of faith open to see the star that guides us to him. The Magi found Jesus, the Messiah, in humble conditions, in simplicity. The power of the simplicity is again manifested. Jesus there in Bethlehem became the new Jerusalem. He, at the moment of his death and resurrection, became light for everyone, for all the peoples. These days, we are invited to be testimonies of the light. We still have difficulty sharing the light of Christ. There are walls that separate us. Certain things we don't discuss in social settings. We are afraid to share our faith. Do we, as Christians, exclude others based upon religion, race, ethnic group, or lifestyle? We need to seek what we have in common and build upon it. It may lead to a different perspective, a different understanding, an experience like that of the Magi. We learn from this passage of the gospel that God, in the person of Jesus, is reaching out to the whole world with no distinctions. I finish my homily connecting what happened in Bethlehem with the homage that gave the Magi to Jesus with some words that Jesus said before his ascension. Go, therefore, make disciples of all nations. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins,
and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The shining light and love of God is made available to all. With gratitude for his guiding presence, let us turn to God with our prayers.
Hear our prayer, hear our prayer. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Hear our
On this Epiphany Day, may the Church radiate the transforming presence of Christ among us and through all the earth. May our parish and our families and all the people of God come to better understand the significance of Jesus for all the peoples of the world. That the divine light be seen and acknowledged by all nations, and for the grace to walk together in this light. The Word became flesh in human history by God's grace. May we have solidarity with those who suffer. May we learn the value of human life and the significance of each life. For Mark and Amy Schaefer, who were married this past weekend, may they have a God-filled marriage. For an increase in vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and consecrated life, that more young men and women will have the courage to follow a call from God to serve the Church. For all who have died this week, Donald Funk, Donald Jaber, Kathleen Jones, and Rosemary Larson, and especially for those remembered at this Mass, John Fuller.
In all our own personal petitions, we pray.
Hear our prayer, hear our prayer. God of mercy, hear our prayer.
God of light and love, you graced us with your only Son and guided the Magi to him so they could carry the news to foreign lands. Listen to our prayers and guide us as we spread the good news in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Our preparation hymn is number 466. That's an error on the board, not 14. 466.
What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet while shepherds watch are keeping? This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste.
Why lies he in such mean estate, where ox and ass are feeding? Good Christian, fear for sinners hear the silent word is pleading. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. So bring him incense, gold, and myrrh. Come, peasant king, to own him, the King of kings salvation brings. Let loving hearts enthrone him. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your hands for the praise and glory of his name. Accept, we pray, O Lord, our offerings in honor of the appearing of your only begotten Son and the first fruits of the nations, that to you praise may be rendered, and eternal salvation be ours through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
To the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today, you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations, and when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes
in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jerome, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us
peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof.
But only say the word,
and my soul shall be healed.
I have an announcement for you. Join Father Alan, formerly of Kiwascam, for an evening of recollection, how to forgive ourselves and others. This Tuesday, January 8th at 6:30 p.m. at Sacred Heart Church. Let us pray. Renewed by sacred nourishment, we implore your mercy, O Lord, that the star of your justice may shine always bright in our minds, and that our true treasure may ever consist in our confession of you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. The Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And now we ask the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary. We say, Hail Mary,
full of grace,
the Lord is with thee.
Blessed art thou among women,
and blessed is the fruit of thy womb,
Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Have a wonderful week.
Our closing hymn is number 463.
Of Orient are bearing gifts, we traverse afar the and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Born a king on Bethlehem's plain, gold I bring to crown him again. King forever, ceasing never, over us all to reign. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to